Hello, Planet Cosplay viewers. I hope you had fun at NDK 2014. We are Kazuha from Japan. I hope you find us on iTunes, Amazon, anywhere.
What do you get when you cross Sailor Moon's cat with a clock?
I don't know.
A lunatic.
As if.
We survived NDK.
It was so much fun, as always.
So many interviews.
So many cosplayers.
The musical guest was a band named Kazaa.
And we've put a music video together to recap.
So let's go ahead and roll it.
Carry me through all.
We have a collection of interviews for you from convention guests and convention cosplayers as well.
Yeah, let's get right to it.
Three. Good morning, John Michael here with Planet Cosplay. And I'm speaking with Dr. Elisa Friedman from the University of Oregon.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes. Hi. Thanks for talking with me.
Yes. How have you been this weekend?
This has been an awesome weekend. Just the energy of everybody here, the knowledge, the excitement. I wish it would go on about like 5 more days or like 5 more years or keep going on.
Wonderful. And so you yesterday I saw your anime panel. That was very packed. Great panel.
Thank you.
It's like, and you really do interact with the students, or I guess the audience very well, just you do in your classes. Tell us a little bit about the class that you hold at the university.
Thanks for asking. I mean, and what you said, too, was very perceptive, that the big secret of teaching is the professors learn more from the students. Mm-hmm. I teach a series of pop culture classes and youth culture classes at Oregon and also in Tokyo, at a few universities in Tokyo. And one of my classes is a freshman seminar, which is nice because everybody's the same age. They're just freshmen. And we choose different topics. Each week we cover something else. In that class, anime is just a part of a larger theme. We look at anime about schoolgirls, schoolboys, freshmen in anime. We look also at fan cultures, at Miyazaki Hayao film, Studio Ghibli films. And we also look at different languages made possible by anime. And one of the exciting things we did last spring is we had a sister class at the University of Tokyo, which were Japanese students who were studying the same topics we were in Japan. And my students would ask them questions, and the Japanese students would ask us questions. So we got to see how anime sort of transcends national boundaries and what the students in different parts of the world like about anime, which was super exciting.
Uh-huh. And then in the spring, you teach a J-pop class?
I do. I teach J-pop. It covers music. It covers literature. The popularity of Japanese culture. And that class is, I've taught a version that had 90 students, and then I teach smaller versions.
Uh-huh. Does it do a history then of a...
Yes, yeah. We take a historical view, even go back as far as the Meiji period, the 19th century, and look at how some of the music we listen to today, the culture we consume today, has its roots in the past.
How did you get involved with this?
It's one of the great things is being able to teach the things that I love. So it came from my own interests. I try to spend 2 to 3 months in Tokyo at least every year. And when I'm there, I just sort of keep an eye on the trends, do a lot of research. And I came into this being a fan and trying to look critically at the things that I love and find ways to see how, for example, anime, music, literature teaches us about our places in the world.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Do you do other items or other things like IndieCon around the country?
This is my first AnimeCon as a guest. I've been a participant in AnimeCon, so it's been super exciting to see things from the inside.
Uh-huh. Are you doing any panels today?
I didn't look at my schedule yet. Okay. Yeah, we have a round table, me and Dr. Ian Condry and Kevin from Robotech. And Kevin, Ian, and I presented together at SANA in 2013, which was really fun. It was a conference held here in Denver to answer the question of why is anime popular? And the audience participants had to write an essay to get in. So it had an interesting academic flavor to it. And the fans just brought so much knowledge. It was a whole day of exchanging knowledge about the role of anime in education, in careers, in daily life.
Uh-huh. Let's get back to your the sister class that you did with the University of Tokyo. Was that right?
Yeah.
How many questions were about Frozen?
Oh, too many. That was the funny thing, that the Tokyo students, the questions that they wanted to ask the University of Oregon students were mostly about Frozen.
Uh-huh.
Frozen is very popular in Japan right now. The songs are everywhere in Japanese and in English. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting to think about, like, we consume anime here in the United States, and in Japan, like, Disney films or Pixar are becoming more and more important.
Which is really unusual for Japan to do that.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for taking the time this morning with us.
And, thank you. This is really kind of you to talk with me.
Oh, yeah. So enjoy the view of the hotel room here.
Yeah, you have an amazing view, and you ask good questions. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm Michael here with PlanetCosplay.com. Press again at NDK2014, hashtag that. Tell me about your group.
We handmade all of our dresses. One of our members who does Black Mage actually made all of our staves. Hers is made of oak. The rest of ours are made of slightly lighter woods, which makes it a little easier. It took us, 6 months to make everything?
Yeah, all together.
About six months.
Name?
Katie.
And your name, Katie?
Yeah.
And the name of our cosplay troupe is Inkblot Society Cosplay, and we are on DeviantArt, and I'm Sarah.
Oh, DeviantArt. Love that.
And I'm Tara.
Tara?
Mm-hmm. I'm Tara.
And Tara. Tara, Tara.
And we've known each other practically our whole lives.
Yes.
Have you been doing cosplay long?
I started in the year 2000.
And I've been doing it with her for 2 years.
Yeah, I've been cosplaying since 2001.
I've been cosplaying since 2007.
What was your first cosplay?
Sailor Neptune. Oh, Sailor Jupiter first from Sailor Moon.
Don't you love the reboot?
I love it.
I mean, Sailor Crystal, but oops, another story there.
So we're so excited.
Ooh, I'm getting goosebumps. What was your first one?
Miyaka priestess costume for Fushigi Yugi.
Really?
Yeah, and then the second one I ever did and I competed in it was Vampire Princess Miyu. Yeah.
Ooh, I want to do a
Miyu too. My first one was Fu from Magic Knight Rayearth.
Sailor Mars, inspired by my sister.
Oh my god, we have the whole sailor.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
We had everybody.
The first time the troop got together, it was a whole sailor.
Was it? See, I did that at Zombie Crawl. Are you guys local?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Oh, are you? I did Zombie Crawl with six people, and we did Sailor Moon Zombie. And we, no, it was like, they were like, wrong. But, and then we all carried like Hello Kitty zombie bags.
That's adorable.
Thank you so much, you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll see you around this weekend. John Michael. Hello, cosplay viewers, Planet Cosplay viewers. This is John Michael, and I'm right now interviewing Kaza. Right? Hello, welcome.
Hello.
So have you had a good con? We're here at NDK 2014.
Yes, it's been 4 years after our first, appearance
time
here. Yeah, it's very, I'm excited.
Uh-huh. You've also done Denver Dragon Boat Festival.
Yes.
Couple of times?
Twice?
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's really a great festival also.
Yeah.
So what's going on? How are you doing? You've got a show at 3 o'clock today. This won't drop till afterwards, but your show last night was wonderful.
Thank you.
And then what's our new album? What's our new CD called?
It's Evolution.
Evolution?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Evolution.
And the first one was?
Overture.
Overture?
Yeah.
And Overture, is that a hearkening back to your classical training?
maybe, I don't know, yeah.
Just a little bit?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Because I do like your Puccini.
Yeah.
Do you do that often anymore or not?
Well, with this band, I'm, kind of busy right now, and then I don't have, my own time to, work on my own, solo.
Uh-huh.
So I don't do much.
No? Okay. It's like, very good. So one of your inspirations that I found out on the web was Kiss.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about Kiss. What do you enjoy about them?
Mainly my guitar. He writes, background of our music. He loves Kiss. And I didn't really know about them before, or I know how they look like, the faces and
uh-huh.
stuff, but I didn't really listen to them. So, my guitar was the, reason that I kind of started to listen to them.
Oh, had gotten into Kiss.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
But I mainly love their, like a feature. How
the
do
look.
You go? Yeah, the look.
Look,
yeah.
Like...
Yeah.
So what's coming up? You're traveling back to Memphis where you're at, and then you're going to be performing there?
We are performing the next, going to be the Nashville.
Nashville.
Yeah, it's the live venue in Nashville, uh-huh. Yeah.
That's a very popular bar also. Yeah. It's real big, and it's like, oh. So have you acclimatized to the altitude here?
A little bit, yes.
A little bit?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So have you gotten out to see Denver, any, or just hotel?
This time, not really. Just inside the hotel, yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Let's get back to Evolution. What's your favorite song on this?
My favorite? Frozen.
You like Frozen? Mm-hmm. What about that do you like? What about it?
I like metal music.
Uh-huh.
You know, heavier music. And Frozen is a little bit of heaviness, you know, like metal, and then in between, you know, pop or rock, mm-hmm. but have a metal sound. I mean, not too much metal, but kind of heavier. Uh-huh. So that's the reason.
And where can our viewers pick this up at? Amazon?
Amazon, iTunes. Yahoo Music. Do you guys have Yahoo Music? What Yahoo Music in
the
US?
Not Yahoo.
Yeah,
we have Sonic Bid, where you can listen to
Sonic,
clips.
And then we are on Spotify, the radio.
Oh, Spotify, mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
And, yeah, pretty much a lot of online, you know, how do you call it?
Uh-huh.
Like sales, distribution, whatever.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And what's your social media sites? What's your websites?
We have our own, you know, homepage, of course, but mainly we use right now Facebook and Reverb Nation. And what else? Yeah, that's about it, maybe, yeah.
Uh-huh.
But before we were more using the MySpace. But, you know, right now MySpace kind of really popular anymore. So, yeah.
I forget my password for that every now and then.
It's think me too.
Well, thank you so much.
Yeah,
thank you
yeah,
so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. Pick up the album, Evolution. Thank you. How are you doing, Presley? Nice to see you again.
I'm doing really good. It's just kind of hard to see, talk in here.
Uh-huh, just like, but it looks incredible.
Thank you.
We've been following your videos as you're making it.
I like how it looks like a cactus at the start.
The what?
It looked kind of like a cactus at the start.
Oh, yeah, when you started, it looked like a cactus.
Yes.
Yeah, like, did you paint the eyes?
Yes, we painted the eyes, but I think, and we used a little Sharpie.
Well, you look great. You look great as always. I hear you're up to 5,000 subscribers on your YouTube.
Yay, I'm excited.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome, and you look great. We'll talk to you later, okay?
All right.
Thank you, Presley.
No problem.
3, 2, 1. Hi, John Michael here with Planet Cosplay. I'm here with Heather Martin. Heather.
Hello.
Hi.
And you're with Art Play Mix?
I am, yes.
How did you make that name?
Oh, gosh. Well, it's a bit of a story. My husband and I, we originally were Art Play Boy, and then we decided that was a little bit too close to Playboy magazine, so we changed it to Art Play Mix because it was the both of us working together.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And his name is James? Jason.
Jason Martin.
Martin.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. And he does the illustrations?
Yes, he does. He's actually been working in the comic book industry since 94, so he's had a lot of experience. He's worked with everybody, Marvel, DC, on just about anything you can name, so I'm very proud of him. Big fan.
And where are you guys out of?
We're out of the Boulder County, Colorado.
Oh, local talent.
Exactly.
Denver! So tell us, and then you're the colorist.
I am.
On these items.
Yes.
Now, we'll be showing some of these and cutaways that we've got going on, and do you have social media?
Oh, yes. Well, I actually just recently got a Facebook. It's less than a week old, as a matter of fact. But no, just for me, but for myself and then my cosplay work. But we do have a regular website for Art Play Mix. It's artplaymix.com, and I don't know if you can see, we've got it up on our little banners here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll have those in the cutaways and in the doobly-doo at the bottom mm-hmm. after this. And tell me about cosplay. What was your first cosplay that you did?
Oh, gosh. That was back in 1996. I was Devil Hunter Yoko. Yeah, so definitely one of the classics, I guess it's considered nowadays.
Very nice, very nice. I have a great, well, I hope you think it's a great question, but if you had unlimited budget, what would you cosplay as?
Oh my goodness, that is a good question. Well, you know, I'm a huge Pokemon fan right now especially, so... Oh, I probably have to look up the most complicated Pokemon costume and then get all sorts of special effects so that I could do, like, electric charges and stuff for people just to have some fun.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and ELs are all the rage now.
Yes.
I wish you had seen me this morning. I was in a shiny Umbreon.
Oh, my gosh. Very nice.
9-foot ears. And so we've got everything going on. How's the con been for you?
It's been great. It's been so crowded. I've just been amazed at how many people made it this year. We've been coming to NDK since, gosh, I think it was 2003 was our first year. So we've been around for a little over 10 years now, and it just keeps on getting bigger and better. The you know people here do a great job.
Uh-huh. And so what are you working on right now?
Well, with the artwork or with the costume work?
Both.
Both, okay. Well, artwork, we're just kind of doing our own thing. My husband is currently working with one of our friends on a zombie project, so that should be interesting. I'm looking forward to coloring some of that. It's different from the usual candy colors that we do, you know. It'll be more dark, kind of gritty, which is fun. And then for cosplay, I've always got something in the works. And right now, again, a lot of Pokemon stuff. It's kind of my my focus at the moment, but... there's, gosh, I've got a closet full of unfinished things that need my attention.
Don't we all?
It seems well, like it.
Well, Heather, thanks for taking a little bit of time.
Oh, it's
get back
pleasure.
To your table and enjoy the con.
Oh, it's very nice to meet you.
2-1, John Michael with PlanetCosplay.com here at NDK 2014, and I'm with?
Tana.
Tana, and tell me about your costume.
So I'm Cortana from Halo 3. And what I did was I basically ordered a bodysuit online, and it was custom fit. It had free custom tailoring. So when I got it, what I did was I took just some basic fabric paint. The brand was Tulip. And
Tulip is really a great fabric paint, isn't it?
Yeah, I was amazed it worked this well on spandex. Really?
Secrets that we'll tell you later.
Secrets. Well, to get the lines on the costume, what I did was I got some double-sided tape from Michaels, and I just taped off the areas that I didn't want painted and then painted in the design.
Ooh, model twirl. Very nice. Hey, John Michael here with Planet Cosplay. I'm here with Crunchyroll. We'll cut that out. But tell us about it, Danica.
So we are the number one anime streaming site in North America, and we have anime, manga, drama, we have a store, and we're basically your one-stop shop for anything Japanese.
And tell them about what we've got going on.
I mean, you know, Danica pretty much summed it up, you know, we're basically all things Japan and Asian pop culture. Right here at Nondescon is our setup for our booth. If you're a premium member and you stop by, you can sign in and get a free Crunchyroll t-shirt or a poster. If you are a premium member, you know, you can definitely come by, sign up for a free 30-day trial, and get the same thing. And, of course, we got our ever-popular live stream that's in the back. You know, you can probably hear it super loud. You know, this is being broadcast live all around the world on the Crunchyroll website.
Really good mic. So
I'm sure they saw. I'm sure they heard that.
No, they did not. And then, so how do they get it if they have Apple TV?
So we actually have an app on Apple TV. It launched about 4 months ago. We're on basically all devices out there. We're on like PS3, PS4, Xbox, Roku, Chromecast, set-top boxes, smart TVs, your phone, your laptop, basically anything, anywhere you want to watch us. We're there.
Hey, John Michael here with PlanetCosplay.com. Again with Kaza. Nice to see you again. Oh, and we're promoting the album. This is number 2, Evolution. Number 1 had Wake Up, and now we have Wake Up 2 coming on to the album, right?
Yeah.
So right now, I'm looking at your costumes that you're having.
Tell me about them.
This company is the, you know, Japanese, outfit company. And the name is Odds On Japan. And then when I was, producing the first album, they were my, being my sponsor. Uh-huh. So, you know, I kind of get to choose what I want to, wear. And then, so right now...
So you had a hand in the design of it.
Yeah, it's like they were letting me choose before they actually sell on the market. Uh-huh. Yeah, so while they're designing, yeah, they let me choose it and then, yeah.
And I hear right now in Japan... that steampunk is very popular.
Oh.
And so this has that look of a steampunk.
Yeah.
Do you know that genre?
I heard about it, but I'm not really, I don't know, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And such a great artist. We saw you last night. We heard you today doing acoustic. Yeah. Tell me about it. See them. And this is Hedic.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
Good, good.
And what band are you with?
Kazuha. I'm a guitarist. Kazuha.
But, okay, so I'm married to like a crazy Kiss fan.
Oh, really?
And he's like, oh, we've got an interview.
This is one of my favorite Kiss t-shirts. I have a couple of t-shirts, Kiss t-shirts.
Uh-huh.
Kiss is, it's like a king of entertainment,
Do you like their music, rock, costumes?
Like costume visual, also makeup.
Uh-huh.
I love
it's
Kiss.
It's very good.
Yeah.
Because I was telling me, she's like, oh, you got to meet the guitarist.
Yeah, I think they are much, they're old. I don't know how old they are, but they are still doing rock music.
They're just a little bit older than I am.
Yeah.
Let's promote the new album.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
This is our second album, the brand new Evolution. Yeah, this is the Evolution tour. We are touring in the United States.
I love Wake Up 2.
Wake Up 2.
Which came, Wake Up 1 was incredible. It hit the charts.
Please try our music. Listen to our music. I love this.
Yeah. Are you having a good con?
Yes. Yes, a lot.
Evolution. Kaza. 1, 2, 3, 4. John Michael here with PlanetCosplay.com, and I'm here with Eli in this great League of Legends outfit. Tell me about it.
Well, the character I'm portraying is Yasuo, the Unforgiven, who is this sort of samurai character of League of Legends. And this is one of his alternate skins, High Noon Yasuo, which is a bit more like cowboy western themed, of course. It's a game that I play a whole lot, and this is just my character of choice.
In the gaming?
Yes.
Twitch it.
I'm planning on it, actually. Yeah, I'm working on setting up a Twitch account.
Oh, they just sold, so tell me how you made the thing.
Okay, so the sword itself is mostly wood. Everything from like the pommel all the way down to the tip of the blade, that's pretty much all wood. The only things that aren't are the gun barrels, which are just PVC, and the guards, which I did a cardboard frame and then put expanding foam into and finished it off with some wood filler on the front. The wood filler is mainly just so I can sand everything into the shape I want, get the inlays and everything. All of the leather working I did myself. It's mostly just sewing it all together, getting everything cut out. The chaps were probably the biggest challenge, just because I had no idea how to make chaps. I found some from a friend of mine, used those to make a pattern, and it kind of went from there. The gun belts, the bullet belt was pretty simple. Just came down to getting the right thickness of leather. The bullets themselves are ping pong ball cut on the tip, wood for the base, and then PVC pipe cut to shape. And then you have just basic sewing fabrics for the bandana as well as the serape.
And you were about to talk about the wig.
Yes, the wig.
Talk about the wig.
Okay, so the wig, in case you can't see, the wig is pretty big. So what I did for this was I took insulation foam, so something...
It looks great.
Thank you. So the insulation foam, it's something just what you would put in the side of your house just to keep it warm. And from there, I cut out the shape of ponytail I'd like and then made that hollow. Once I got that all hollowed out, I used wig wefts, which are just long strands of like wig fibers, and wrapped those around the entirety of the ponytail and shaped them.
You basically wove it.
Yes, yes. Okay. And then from there, I made this aluminum frame, which it's just like a cross shape. So I've got one going from the back of my head to the front, and then from side to side. And that's all held together by screws and bolts and such, and that drills directly into the foam of the ponytail. The crucial challenge of this was that originally the frame was not staying on my head by itself, but that was before I put the base wig on. What I found out was because the base wig itself has a elastic band on the inside, once I put that on, it holds... Once I put that on, it holds the entire thing. It's just kind of self-supporting at this point. Yeah.
Well, it looks great. Your outfit is incredible. Are you having a good con?
Yes.
This is day one.
I'm really enjoying it. Been coming here for the past 5 or 6 years, but have never done a cosplay quite this intricate. But I'm really happy with it.
Well, you've done quite well. Thank you, Eli.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Yes, my name is Robbie Damons, and I'm playing Tuxedo Mask in Sailor Moon.
Yes, right now, I think as far as Viz is concerned, we're just talking about the original series. I don't think the plans for Crystal are out yet, but we'll see. You know, we're hopeful. But yes, it is the original 200, all three movies, stars, and it's all uncut, uncensored. But I've always been in the arts. I started doing professional theater when I was very, very young, and it paved my way through college, through undergrad, and graduate school. So when I graduated graduate school at 25, I knew that I wanted to continue on, so it was either New York or Los Angeles for me, and I was interested in film and television and voiceover. And from what I understood, it sort of goes, you know, New York, Texas, Los Angeles, sort of for quantity of work that's out there, Los Angeles being the biggest. So it was a natural move for me, and I've been fortunate enough to remain working, which is a hard thing to do, you know. So voiceover has been very good to me throughout the years. I can promote this if you like traditional cartoons. I'm on Breadwinners, which is a Saturday morning cartoon right in between SpongeBob and Sanjay and Craig on Nickelodeon every Saturday morning. I think it's at 10:30, 11 o'clock, and it's a crazy, wacky, fun show, especially if you've got kids. It's totally safe for kids, but adults seem to enjoy. There are a few jokes for adults in there, and we're premiering new episodes, I believe, on the weekend of the 20th. So that's coming up. We've been on our summer hiatus. And I've got a new video game called Fairy Fencer F that comes out. That's a Japanese sort of RPG fighting style game. And that'll be out on Tuesday, the 16th of this month. And Final Fantasy Type Zero should be coming out sometime within the next year. I'm in that as well. And And if you ever want to hang out online, if you're a fan of anime, video games, cartoons, pretty much anything nerdy, you can find me on Twitter or Facebook, and I will talk to you as long as we keep it cool. Nothing too personal, I guess. But I love to talk about that kind of stuff. Yeah.
Once again, MDK lived up to its stellar reputation in the Colorado cosplay scene.
Coming up, we have a pretty busy October with Rocky Mountain Con, Mile High Con, and Running of the Leaves.
And don't forget Zombie Crawl.
Until then, keep cosplaying.
Oh.